Hello viewers, here we have our giant personality, Professor of Horticulture, Dilip Kumar Dora sir. He is the former Dean PGA-DRI, Odisha University of Agriculture and Technology, Bhubaneswar. Sir, namaste.
Namaste.
Sir, how do you feel after coming to our campus, that is GIT Guntur?
Well, I have been here since last 4 days, and as I see the campus, it has got a very rich landscape. In the morning hours when I used to go around the campus, I feel very comfortable. So what I feel is students residing here and studying, they can enjoy the landscape of this campus and the beautiful environment for their academic enrichment.
Yes, sir, we have prepared some questions we would like to ask. Yes, what are the main horticultural crops that could be taken off commercial scale in Odisha? So what would you like to suggest to Odisha farmers?
This is a very broad question. Odisha, I consider, is a mini India, because Odisha has got typical tropical, typical subtropical, and large ranges of cooler parts. So this area of starting from Baleswar to Ganjam is a coastal tract. This is almost 480 kilometers. This tract could be considered as typically tropical, and crops like coconut, cashew, and in that little bit interior part you can grow banana, mango, sapota very comfortably. And after introduction of National Horticulture Mission in 2005-06, the state has gained momentum as far as planting of horticultural crops is concerned. Once upon a time, this state was depending upon Andhra Pradesh and West Bengal for mango. Now we have got surplus mango, which could be used apart from table purpose for processing purpose also. And then coming to Western Orissa, which is I consider as a typical subtropical region, where the crops like, you know, this bear, pomegranate could be promoted on commercial scale. And as far as Orissa, western part of this state is concerned, onion, which is considered as a cash crop, could be grown very much commercially, but there are certain changes which are needed in the cropping system. So short duration paddy, thereafter onion, so that paddy and onion can produce the best yield. And onion is a potential crop. Apart from that, bananas and other crops are being grown, but because this is subtropical, I would again like to emphasize on the production of bear and pomegranate. These are high value crops, and also onion.
But sir, if we see in the recent years,
and another thing which I left is this cooler parts means Daringbadi, where temperature often sometimes goes -1-2 degrees Celsius. They are high value vegetable crops, temperate crops like broccoli, Brussels sprouts, red cabbage, lettuce, Chinese cabbage. These rare vegetables, asparagus, these things could be produced apart from regular crops. And high value vegetables like cauliflower, cabbage, cherry tomato, these things also could be produced. But there are many parts other than Daringbadi, some parts of Mayurbhanj, some parts of Keunjhar, some parts of Koraput, the hilly areas which are reasonably cooler, those parts could be utilized for growing such high value.
Lychee
in Devgad area. Yes. Lychee in Devgad area, that could be grown as a high value crop. But as far as crops are concerned, we have to be very careful in choosing the crops for specific agroecological situations. the state has got 10 agroecological zones. But you know, 10 agroecological zones, that could that has again been further subdivided into 61 farming situations. So those 61 farming situations individually need to be explored as far as cropping system is concerned. So it has to be very carefully planned, and the planned concept must be properly executed. Then the state will gain.
Sir, in the recent years, the post-harvest loss is very much high. So what do you think the remedial measures can be adopted?
Very correct question you have asked. This has become a subject of concern, because when produce is lost, I take it quite amiss, because with lots of constraints, by putting in very expensive inputs, we are producing horticultural produce. But produce is lost. It does not enjoy the kind of market security that it deserves. Then production venture is a meaningless venture. Hence, now it is high time for the government and for all of us, we must put lot of importance on proper post-harvest management of the horticultural produce, particularly perishable horticultural produce. 20% of the produce is lost. So, if you can check that loss and bring it to a minimum, it cannot be zero. Post-harvest loss could be brought to the minimum level, then per capita availability of fruits, vegetables, flowers could be increased without further expansion of area, without further in use of expensive inputs. So this is a subject which deserves concern, both at the government level, also at the private level.
And sir, if you see in present scenario, a lot of students, they are making interest towards agriculture rather than engineering and medical. So what are the main scopes that a BSc professional carry after completion of 4 years?
I do not want to compare agriculture, horticulture with engineering and medicine. Each technical subject has its own importance, I would like to say. But as far as agriculture and horticulture is concerned, most of the people, they have got an inbuilt mindset that this is a losing concern, not at all a losing concern, because proper attention is not paid to the marketing of the horticultural or agricultural produce, value addition. So post-harvest loss has to be checked, and there is plenty of scope for production and value addition. There is no question. What do you ask me?
What are the main
scopes
that a
BSc professional have? Professionals, you know, they are in a mood to get into government sector, government jobs. But if you ask me honestly, I find lot of opportunities for the agri-horticultural graduates in private sector also. Both in production sector and post-harvest management sector, processing, value addition. But one has to come up with that kind of mindset. Suppose I take the example of one girl student who later on gets married and becomes a housewife. So she can start one spice industry on her own. Raw materials are available. You can collect and process them, produce spices, quality spices, market them, earn money. And there is plenty of scope for processing. Best example is cashew. Cashew in our state, about 8 to 10 lakh tons of cashew apple, which go west. So if that could be processed and quality drinks which are very rich in vitamin C could be produced and marketed, then you save the produce from the post-harvest loss and can add value, earn money. Like that mangoes which now, once upon a time, as I told, we are depending upon Andhra Pradesh and West Bengal for our mango requirement. Now this state has got surplus mangoes after introduction of NHM in 2005-06. Now it is high time for us to think how to get into processing sector for value addition, so that the surplus mangoes which cannot get into table market, that could be better utilized for processing purpose, for pulp production, for juice. Nowadays there is much demand of fresh juices in the market rather than on these synthetic drinks. ଓଡ଼ିଶା କୃଷକମାନଙ୍କର କୌଣସି ଅସୁବିଧା ନାହିଁ, କିନ୍ତୁ ସେମାନେ ଉନ୍ନତମାନର ବିହନ ବ୍ୟବହାର ବେଳେବେଳେ କରୁନାହାନ୍ତି। ଯଦି ବି ଉନ୍ନତମାନର ବ୍ୟବହାର ବିହନ ବ୍ୟବହାର କରୁଛନ୍ତି, ତା ପରବର୍ତ୍ତୀ ଅବସ୍ଥାରେ ଏମାନେ ଆମର ଯେଉଁ ରେକମେଣ୍ଡେଡ୍ ପ୍ୟାକେଜ୍ ଅଫ୍ ପ୍ରାକ୍ଟିସ୍, ଆମେ ଯେଉଁଟାକୁ କହୁଛୁ ଜଳସେଚନ, ଆବଶ୍ୟକୀୟ ଜଳସେଚନର ବ୍ୟବସ୍ଥା, ଆବଶ୍ୟକୀୟ ଖତ ସାର ତାର ଉଚିତ ପରିଚାଳନା, ରୋଗ ପୋକ ପରିଚାଳନା, ତେଣୁ ଏସବୁ ଜିନିଷ ଗୁଡ଼ାକ ସେମାନେ ଠିକ୍ ଭାବରେ କରିପାରୁନଥିବାରୁ ସେମାନେ ଆବଶ୍ୟକୀୟ ଅମଳ ପାଉନାହାନ୍ତି। ତେଣୁ ଏଥିପାଇଁ ମୋର ଗୋଟେ ନିର୍ଦ୍ଦିଷ୍ଟ ମୋର ମତାମତ ହେଲା, ସେମାନେ ଯେକୌଣସି ପନିପରିବା ଫଳ ଯାହା ବି ଚାଷ କରିବା ପୂର୍ବରୁ, କି ନଡ଼ିଆ କାଜୁ ଯାହା ବି ଚାଷ କରିବା ପୂର୍ବରୁ, ସେମାନେ ଉଚିତ ଜାଗାରୁ ତାଙ୍କର ବିହନ ସଂଗ୍ରହ କରନ୍ତୁ, ଭଲ ଉନ୍ନତମାନର ଚାରା ସଂଗ୍ରହ କରନ୍ତୁ, ଉନ୍ନତମାନର ଗ୍ରାଫ୍ଟେଡ୍ ମ୍ୟାଟେରିଆଲ ଯେମିତି କାଜୁ ହେଲା, ତା'ର ଭଲ ମ୍ୟାଙ୍ଗୋ ହେଲା, ଭଲ ଉନ୍ନତମାନର ଗ୍ରାଫ୍ଟ ସଂଗ୍ରହ କରନ୍ତୁ। କରିସାରିଲା ପରେ ଆବଶ୍ୟକୀୟ ଜଳସେଚନ, ଯେମିତି ଆମେ ବର୍ତ୍ତମାନ ବୁନ୍ଦା ଜଳସେଚନର କଥା କହୁଛୁ, ଆଉ ଫର୍ଟିଗେସନ୍ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ କଥା କହୁଛୁ, ଏଗୁଡ଼ାକ ସବୁ କରିବା ପାଇଁ ଆପଣମାନେ ଆମ ବିଶ୍ୱବିଦ୍ୟାଳୟର ଯେଉଁ ଉଦ୍ୟାନ କି ଅନ୍ୟାନ୍ୟ ବିଭାଗର ବିଶେଷଜ୍ଞମାନେ ରହିଛନ୍ତି, ସେମାନଙ୍କ ସମ୍ପର୍କରେ ଆସନ୍ତୁ, ସେମାନଙ୍କୁ ପଚାରିକରି ବ୍ୟବସାୟ ଭିତ୍ତିକ ଉଦ୍ୟାନ କୃଷିରେ କିପରି ସଫଳ ରୂପାୟନ କରିପାରିବେ ଏ ଜିନିଷକୁ, ତା ପାଇଁ କଲେ ଭଲ ଅମଳ ହେବ। ଆଉ ଯଦି ଆମେ କାଜୁର ଆମର ଅମଳ ବହୁତ କମ୍, ନଡ଼ିଆରେ ଗଛ ପିଛା ଅମଳ ବହୁତ କମ୍, ତା'ର କାରଣ ହେଉଛି ଆମେ ତାକୁ ପାଣି ଜଳସେଚନର ଆବଶ୍ୟକ ଜଳସେଚନ ପରିଚାଳନା ଠିକ୍ ଭାବରେ କରୁନାହୁଁ, ଆବଶ୍ୟକ ପରିମାଣର ଖତ ସାର ଦେଉନାହୁଁ, ଆଉ ଯେଉଁ ରୋଗ ପୋକ ରହିଛି ତା'ର ପରିଚାଳନା ମଧ୍ୟ ଠିକ୍ ଭାବରେ କରୁନାହୁଁ। ଆମର ବିଭାଗୀୟ ଅଧିକାରୀମାନେ ଅଛନ୍ତି, ଆଉ ବିଶ୍ୱବିଦ୍ୟାଳୟରେ ଆମର କୃଷି ବିଶ୍ୱବିଦ୍ୟାଳୟରେ ବିଶେଷଜ୍ଞମାନେ ମଧ୍ୟ ଅଛନ୍ତି। ବିଶେଷଜ୍ଞମାନଙ୍କୁ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆପଣ ଗୋଟେ ବଡ଼ 20 ଏକର କି 40 ଏକର କି 50 ଏକର ଏରିଆରେ କୌଣସି ଫସଲ ଲଗାଇବାକୁ ଯାଉଛନ୍ତି, ସେମାନଙ୍କୁ ପଚାରିକରି ସେ ଭିତରକୁ ପଶନ୍ତୁ, ନିଶ୍ଚୟ ଅମଳ ଅଧିକା ହେବ, ନିଶ୍ଚୟ ଲାଭବାନ ହେବେ। ଆଉ ତା ସାଙ୍ଗରେ ଅମଳ ଯାହା ବି ହେବ ତାକୁ ଠିକ୍ ଭାବରେ କେମିତି ମାର୍କେଟକୁ ଛାଡ଼ିବେ ସେ ବ୍ୟବସ୍ଥା ମଧ୍ୟ ଆପଣ କରିବା ଉଚିତ।
Thank you so much, sir, for sharing your knowledge and giving us your precious time.
Thank you very much for inviting me. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.